Hello everyone and welcome to the Finland Academy and Android Software. So in the series of the week gone by, today it is in the end of week as well as the end of month. So we start within a monthly chart. That means on a monthly chart the index has improved by near about 3.5%. But with this improvement, prices has approached to its resistance band, and from that it has faced some sorts of selling pressure. So if we put it on the chart, so the resistance band looks like this. This is what our last turning candle that we can see, or inception point of the fall. So in the inception point of the fall, index has entered, and from there we have seen the reactions. So on the monthly chart, somewhat we can see that it has formed a shooting star from the resistance band. Secondly, if we look at a weekly chart to shrink that white resistance band. So let's say if we are at a weekly charts, so in the weekly chart we can understand that means prices has reacted actually from this level. So this is an inception point of the fall, from where the major declining momentum that we have seen. So if I'm just squeezing the resistance band on a weekly chart, so this is how it comes up. So I just take out from the monthly chart or monthly resistance band. So this is how it looks like. So in the weekly resistance band, prices from past 4 weeks, also effectively it is an entire October month, the prices has kept on facing the resistance at the 12,000 level, and from there we have kept on seeing a certain kind of the reactions over there. So looking at the prior two candles, it looks like a bearish engulfing candle. So on a monthly chart, the shooting star; on the weekly chart, it is in a bearish engulfing pattern, and it is emerging from the very key level. So yes, it indicates a certain kind of the weakness at the top. On a daily chart, the prices has been into the range for a long time in a one range. Means on the higher side, it was a 12,000 level, and on the lower side, it is in a 11,700 level. So this is what a range, a broader range we can say, where the prices has spent a good amount of time. But as the days has processed, we are seeing that means prices has moved below this range, or it has minutely taken out this level. So of course it creates a certain kind of the short-term weakness structure over here. But we need to have a certain kind of the trigger point, that means up to what level we remain on the negative side or on the bearish side. So just to identify a certain kind of a trigger level, we look at a intraday chart or a 60-minute chart, because over there we get a little bit more detailings. And the reason and purpose to do so is that means we cannot be in perpetually negative. Means there has to be some point where we can call ourselves that means this is what a bearish camp or bear's zone is there, and beyond that the prices are on the, or bears has given their grip and the bulls has taken over. But for that purpose we need to have the trigger point. So for a very short term perspective, the bearishness likely to prevail as far as prices are below 11,750 for a very short term perspective, if we can say. A little bit of broader perspective, prices remains under the bear's zone as far as this resistance band is intact. Fine. So let's say for a short term, 11,750 will be our trigger level. So we can say that up to that means there is a bearishness structure. If any kind of the improvement happens, or the positional trader can view it from that perspective, that means 11,930 to 11,550, as far as these levels are holds, there is a presence of a bearishness. Fine. From which point we can see a certain kind of the more negativity. So of course we have seen the breakdown, but whenever we see the breakdown, there is an equivalent chance of a bear trap as well. So for that purpose, what the caution that we take is that means we try to understand the next best support level. So let's say in this case, this is what level that we are witnessing right now, 11,650, the lower band of the consolidation patch. And just immediately there means this is what the important support level that we are seeing. So last time it has acted as in a resistance. So once the resistance has taken out, so it has acted as per a role reversal concept, it is now the immediate support level. So once this support level is breaching, so it adds a further to the negativity. So this is what a broader structures are there. This is what the important key levels are there, from where what we need to look for. And if a price is showing a certain kind of negativity, so yes, means there will be a kind of the intermediate support levels like this. So these are the kind of levels which happens in between the immediate support level over here, or the next best support levels will be this one. But the short term structure remains a weak, and we have defined what kind of the key levels are there which holds a negativity, and afterwards the bulls can take over. whatever the discussions that we are doing, that is for educational purpose only. Thank you so much.